Let us look at the resistance of a hollow sphere. Hollow sphere of inner radius A and the outer radius B. I have put in some little bit of effort in trying to visualize the resistance, like why integration is required in case of a hollow cylinder, because of the increasing area of cross section and slowly increasing, a continuously increasing area of cross section. If there is a fixed area of cross section, you can simply write resistance is equal to rho into length of the conductor by area of cross section. Because the area of cross section keeps on increasing, every small element you have to find the resistance and then you have to sum it up for infinite number, and that is done by integration. And suppose if you have not understood, and it will be better if you just watch that resistance of a hollow cylinder and then come back to this, you may be able to understand it better. Suppose between the inner surface and the outer surface, means they are connecting the positive terminal over here and the negative terminal is taken out and connected here. So here basically negative terminal connected and here basically positive terminal connected. So that does not mean current go from here to here. Since it is positive terminal is connected inside, every point on this inner surface is a positive potential. Every point on the outer surface is negative potential. Hence the current goes radially outward from inner surface of the sphere to the outer surface of the sphere. Hence what you are supposed to do is, from the center at a distance x, you consider an elemental sphere of thickness, a spherical shell of thickness dx, and the current is going this way. So this dx is the length of the conductor, and area of cross section of this sphere is the area of cross section of the conductor. We know that resistance is equal to rho into L by A. Here at a distance x, the thickness of the conductor is dx. So current is crossing this way, that is why length of the conductor is dx. So because it is an elemental sphere, small element of the entire conductor, the total resistance is maybe R. The resistance of that element is only dr. dr will be equal to rho into L is basically x by area of cross section. Because it is a small thickness, when you consider in a sphere, so the inner surface of the sphere will be 4 pi, area of the sphere will be 4 pi r square. Because it is at a distance x, the surface area is going to be 4 pi x square. Because it is very small thickness, both the inner and the outer surface of area of cross section is going to be the same, 4 pi x square. So in this area you'll be writing 4 pi x square. So what is the total resistance? This element you have to take from the inner ring, inner surface to the outer surface. So from A, 2 pi x dx 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 and so on up till the total radius becomes B. So the total resistance R will be equal to integral of dr, and that integration is taken from A to B. So integral rho dx by 4 pi x square from A to B. So rho by 4 pi integral x power minus 2 dx from A to B. So this is rho by 4 pi integral of x power minus 2 dx is x power minus 2 plus 1, so that is divided by minus 2 plus 1. So x power minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1 is minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1, so it is minus. So okay, I'll write it like this, plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1, so it is minus 1 by x. So the resistance R will be equal to rho by 4 pi into minus 1 by x from A to B. So rho by 4 pi into 1 by A minus 1 by B. Upper limit minus lower limit is minus 1 by B minus of minus 1 by A. So that becomes 1 by A minus 1 by B. So the resistance of a hollow sphere of inner radius A and outer radius B will be equal to rho by 4 pi into 1 by A minus 1 by B. And this can also be written as rho by 4 pi So AB, B minus EA. So it is B minus EA by AB. This way also you can be writing it.